I want to turn again to this searing moment in North Carolina where the president stood in silence as his supporters launched into this chant. It's a clear sign that the president's racist message against Congresswoman Ilhan Omar and three other Democratic women of color is resonating with his base. Joe Biden just weighed in on this. Let's listen.
Well, I only saw a clip of it. The way he stood there, it didn't seem like it. You'd assume, you can imagine if someone said that when I was speaking, what I would have said. No, stop. Speak up, man. Not after the fact. Not after the fact. And look.
I want to bring in Van Jones. He's our CNN political commentator and host of CNN's The Redemption Project and Van Jones Show. Van, the president said today he didn't like that chant. He said, quote, I was not happy with it. I disagree with it. But again, I didn't say that. They did. What do you make of how this all escalated last night?
Well, first, let me just say that last night was terrifying. To have the leader of the free world, the most powerful man in the world, to stand there and you have tens of thousands of people chanting, send her back, focusing all that on an individual U.S. citizen, a lawmaker, is terrifying. Any leader in the world standing up on the stage like that with that kind of a crowd singling out a citizen would be terrifying, period. We also have to remember Ilhan Omar in particular has already been somebody who's been convicted for threatening her life. And so he's playing with a very, very dangerous kind of fire. That said, I'm glad he's pulling back. He might lie about what he did, but if he's sending a signal now that he doesn't want to go down that road, I think that's a good thing.
Will that stop the chance in future rallies?
Listen,
I think back to lock her up build the wall.
If that particular chant becomes a part of the foundation for his campaign, that's dangerous for the whole country. I don't understand why he does stuff like this. Listen, he could run on something positive. He's got an economy he could talk about. He's got achievements he could talk about. Instead, he goes the low road, the dirty road. He's scraping the bottom of the barrel and coming up with splinters and serving those up to the American people when he's got other stuff to do. And it's dangerous and it's wrong. For me in particular, I don't think we've done as good a job as we could explaining to people why this send people back stuff is so painful. If you're a little black kid in America, one of the things that happens to you on the school ground is go back to Africa, go back to Africa, go back to Africa. It's the first time you even realize you're not just like every other kid. You're like, what are you talking about? I've never been to Africa. Go back to Africa. So this, it's not just like a casual thing. Also, when there's a hate crime, often, right before the shot is fired, right before the punch is thrown, go back where you came from. So this is very chilling stuff. This is very dangerous stuff. And I think the Republican Party, behind closed doors, must have been really, really trying to lay down a line. I hope he keeps backing up off of this. But if he doesn't, we are in deep trouble.
I mean, this sort of harkens back to other times in American history, this appeal to emotion rather than, you know, rational arguments, George Wallace, Joseph McCarthy. But, you know, the president's supporters say this isn't about race, this is about policy.
I mean, it's just a lie. That's not true. I mean, listen, when you say go back to the crime-infested, you know, country that you came from, and three of the four people are from the United States of America, that is about race. And people said it 1,000 times, but it's worth saying over and over again. He never said that about Bernie Sanders. He's never said that about any white critic of the country, including his own white self. Trump himself has been the biggest critic of the United States of anybody, especially when Obama was president. Nobody would have ever said to him, well, go back where you came from. It wouldn't even make sense. Go back where you came from only makes sense inside the logic of white nationalism, white supremacy, white people belong here, other people don't. White people can criticize. Bernie can criticize. Trump can criticize. But if you're a brown woman with a hijab on, you can't criticize. Well, listen, that is about race. And you don't have to use a racial epithet or say the word black or Muslim or Latino or whatever for it to be about race. In the context, it's obvious. Here's the deal. I don't understand why he does stuff like this. When you have an economy this strong, when you have, you know, past stuff that you're proud of, tax stuff and dealing with, you know, foreign policy, run on that. What are you doing? Why are you you're going down the sewer, dragging stuff up for dinner? You don't have to do it. It's wrong to do it. And I tell you what, if the Republican Party doesn't find a bigger backbone in public, obviously behind the closed doors, people are doing stuff, you run the risk of the party of Lincoln, becoming the party of Steve Bannon forever. And that is something that will hurt the entire country. Democrats should be just as concerned about the Republicans going this way. Somebody told me, well,
President Trump says he thinks this is a winning strategy.
Well, listen, it could be a winning strategy in the short term for his presidential bid, but it's a losing strategy for the country. And also, I'm just not sure. I think that there's a silent majority of people who have been getting increasingly uncomfortable with what Trump is up to. And the question they're going to be asking is, can I keep this economic progress without this social regress? What Trump is basically doing is he's bringing the economy up, but he's pulling the society apart. You got to have some people saying, is there somebody that can keep the economy coming up but bring us back together? If the Democrats nominate somebody credible on both counts, Trump's in trouble. And this strategy is going to be something he regrets.
Van Jones, as always, thank you.